Bueno, entonces yo decía, no, pues van a decir que ya rápido me acabe el crédito, entonces está bien así. Menos porque los clientes, dámelos, pero tampoco los entiendan, pues ya ves que aprendes a trabajar con la aplicación, a trabajar a los clientes, a cobrarle, a cobrar. Pero me dan medio millón de pesos y yo los cobro una
¿Qué onda,
multa de
Isi?
60
Oye, no te mandé
la
la...
barra.
¿Qué onda?
La respuesta, güey. Te las mando al rato, sale. Se me fue el rollo ayer, la neta. Ya no volví a mirar el grupo ahí.
Está bueno, ya
Y se me
está.
fueron dos, tres. No creas que las agarré todas, ¿eh?
Ah, no te preocupes.
Estaba sin chinga ahí apuntándolas. Pero ahí te las paso, güey. ¿Qué onda? ¿Cómo anda?
Bien, bien, aquí. ¿Y tú qué rollo?
También aquí chambeando todavía. Te mando un correo aquí.
Órale, ¿a qué hora sales, pues?
Y a las 7, pero pues me meto al inglés a las 6 y ya, ya para cuando salgo ya no hay nadie, aquí ya se van todos.
Pero allá te quedas, o sea, tienes
Sí.
allá,
Y
es
güey,
como campamento,
campamento.
así,
Sí,
órale, órale.
campamento.
Ok, y tienes tu barraca para ti solo o la compartes.
No, no, a mí solo.
Ah, está chingón. ¿Ahí qué eres? ¿Gerente de algo?
De proceso, sí.
Órale. Está bien.
Imagine having a roomie, Javier. It would be
Iba a ser un desmadre
at
ahí.
this at
Only this.
if the rooming will be a lady, no problem for me.
Ay. Your wife is gonna
Antes de
say
que
something.
entre Yoli y René.
Yeah, they are connecting their audio right now.
Yes.
No, that would be impossible for having a roommate, right? No. What's up, guys? How are you? Everything
Hi,
good?
hi, good afternoon.
We are miners. Remember that.
What is that supposed to mean? Tell me.
It's very difficult, the miner life.
Yes, man. I totally understand.
And we need a looking for this stress.
I mean, take it easy with your words.
Yeah, take it easy. Renee is here.
Renee is connected. What's up, Renee? How are you doing?
I'm okay.
Ready
Ready
to
to the
prep,
class.
Renee. Yesterday, very good yesterday, Renee.
Yeah, thank you. Yo también me sentí muy bien.
It
Bueno,
was good yesterday.
todos mis días hemos mejorado muchísimo.
La Lupita pidió ahí. ¿Qué pidió en el grupo, verdad? No me acuerdo. A
Right
ver,
now?
hace
Ah,
ratito.
the class.
La clase de ayer.
Oh, yeah. It's in YouTube, but I didn't send the link this time. Sorry.
Pensé que estaba pidiendo el audio, qué cosa que tampoco yo he pedido.
Oh, we had an audio, that's correct. Ni el teacher ni los students. Oh my gosh. No se hace uno, no se hace uno. Esta vida adulta ya no la quiero, René.
Me too.
I want to be a child again. Do you want to be a child again, Jason?
Pues por unas cosas sí, por otras cosas no. No, ya, vamos bien en el ¿cómo se dice? En la etapa de vivencia de uno.
In the timeline.
Ya.
Yeah. I know. I'm
No hay de
happy.
otra
This
más
I
que
am very happy. In this age, I'm very happy with my life. Finally, oh my God.
Mi hermano me dice, hay que chingarle como negro para gastar como güerito.
Oye,
That's right.
pero a veces ni llegamos a querernos ni siquiera medio blanquearnos. Para que uno le chingue nomás, no.
What's up, Jolie? You're connected.
Teacher, I think my internet is very bad. I turn off the video.
Okay. All
Well,
right.
I will
do the class.
Put the megas porque
ah,
sí
okay.
estamos.
All right. Today we have free speech. What's up, Julie? How are you?
Hello, teacher.
Are you running?
Oh, pensé que no iba a haber speech al principio.
Nah, it's a improvising speech. That's what I want.
Ay, Dios, no preparé nada.
It's okay. It's okay. Maybe I can help you. Don't worry. Ready, JC? You're going to be the first one.
Okay.
All right. Go for it.
Well, today I talked with the lady of the painting business, you know, and I was looking for a local, ¿cómo es? Local? Local?
Yeah.
Rent local. I saw one of them in Solidaridad in front of Telcel, you know?
Yes.
It's on the corner that I guess is Santa Fe Square, but I don't like too much because the place is in the corner in the wall and all the locals and the parking lot was at noon and was very very full and
okay.
I need more space for the customers that they want to buy a paint or something like that. I don't know.
Very good, excellent, JC. Only one observation.
Yes.
I don't like too much. You are referring to the local rental, right?
Yes.
Okay. I don't like it too much.
All right.
I don't like it. You
okay.
know that rental place.
All right. Yeah.
Perfect grammar, everything. What's up, Mr. Alfredo? How are you?
Hello, mister. Hello, guys.
Hello.
And you?
Good. Doing good,
yeah,
man.
Good. Here
are
in Hermosillo.
Are you back in Hermosillo?
Yeah. Perdiendo el calor. It's too humid, you know?
Yes. I hate it. Oh my God, I hate it.
Yeah.
Yep.
But it's
gonna...
some clouds now, but not too much to refresh.
Yeah, and sometimes you don't want the rain because the next day is worse.
Yeah.
Right?
Like the tamales.
Yes, that's something like that, like a sauna. All right. Ready, René, for your speech?
I think yes.
Okay. Talk to us.
Okay. Hi, guys. Good afternoon. The next weekend, it is a party for my town. It's a... I don't know, it's a monument. The name is La Virgen del Rosario. It's a tradition for a long years for the two towns, Suaqui Grande and La Comuripa. The people walk around the river or the route caminos así, terracería, routes. The day is 8th of September. 14th reason, I need to clean my room and acomodar las cosas de cuarto. Because my family, we come back to my house. We will stay here and we will sleep in my room.
Excellent, Renee. Only four observations.
Okay.
It is a Paris. It is a party.
Okay,
it is a Paris. Is a party.
Mm-hmm.
That is singular and plural. Pronunciation for river.
River.
River. River. Yeah. Pronunciation for, you say routes, como rutas.
Uh-huh.
Right? It's routes.
Routes. Routes.
Routes.
Routes. Okay.
Routes. Routes.
Routes. Routes. Route.
And acomodar, you could have said, or organize.
Organize. Maybe. Sí, es que la verdad no me acordé de nada.
Don't worry. That's part of the thing. Ready, Jolly? What's
Están
up, Lupita?
Invitados.
How are you? Thank you.
Ay, baile.
Good afternoon, guys.
How are you, Lupita? How are you doing?
I'm good, teacher. Thank you.
Excellent. Better than yesterday? Did you drink coffee today?
Yes.
Yes, that's good. That's good. All right. I'm going to go with... Alfredo, are you ready, mister? Free speech?
For what? Okay. For free speech?
Yes.
Today I arrived at Hermosillo. I take 5 days of rest. I come back to mine on Monday, is the idea, or maybe on Tuesday. This weekend will be a little busy, but it's an interesting because tomorrow we will visit Orsia, ¿cómo era obra de teatro? A play. Play. Well, Rancheros played on downtown here in Hermosillo Friday. My little daughter have a small party, and Saturday my wife and I will go at Alejandro Fernandez concert. And Sunday just take a real rest.
Okay.
And Monday, go to the site.
Go back to site. Very good, Alfredo. Two observations only. You say days of rest.
Mm-hmm.
I'm here to take my days of rest. I would recommend you to use my days off.
Days off. Okay.
My days off. And then you say, my little daughter have a party, right?
Uh-huh.
My little daughter has a party.
Okay, yeah.
And so everything else was perfect. Everything else was good.
Teacher, day off is for días de descanso, and rest is when you take 20 minutes for rest, yeah?
I mean... If you say days of rest, I don't know if it exists, the concept, you know, because the concept per se is days off, you know?
Okay.
But
I remember old boss, and he used that word.
Days of rest?
Hey, Alfredo, when you take your days of rest,
maybe it is a concept that I don't know, right? Maybe. Maybe it is correct. Days of rest.
He was a Canadian, maybe.
Yeah, exactly. Maybe. Good, good, good. Yeah. Ready, Jolie? Now you are?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Okay. The last Saturday, I invited my husband to go to the cinema. And I am happy for three reasons. The first one is because finally I showed the film. The second is because the movie was in English. And then I tried to read the subtitles, and I put attention in the audio, and I was happy because I understood 80% of the movie, and I catch new expressions. And the third reason is because I think it is one of the most beautiful stories that I have been in the cine. I am impactada, amazing. Oh, no recuerdo la palabra.
Amazed.
Amazing. Ajá.
My God, Julie.
With the story.
Excellent. Only one thing, I didn't understand the first reason. What was the first reason?
No, no, es que I will wait.
Okay.
Okay. Es que no recuerdo ni siquiera. Ahí me hice bolas un
poquito. You are improvising?
Mande.
Are you improvising?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Everything perfect, only one thing. You say, I try to didn't read.
Traté de no leer. Es lo que quise decir, traté de no leer, pero no sé cómo decirlo.
¿Cómo dirían traté de no leer?
I couldn't read. No, I didn't try to read.
No.
No, porque ahí sería I didn't try to, no intenté leer.
Okay. No sé, no supe cómo
intenté
decirlo.
No leer, eso no se los he enseñado, ¿eh?
Intenté no leer.
No leer. Look. I tried not to read.
I tried
because it's in past, right? I tried not to read.
Oh.
Not to read.
Oh,
okay. I try not to read. So usually they say, try not to pay attention to the problems. Continue with your life.
Okay.
You know? Try not to. Okay.
Try.
Everything good, Jolie. Good. And congratulations on the movie. Good for you. Ready, Mr. Javier? Come on, man.
What is the
free?
Free.
Okay, it's free. Okay.
You got it.
Yes.
There you go.
Today we received two new releases about the project. The last one is 1 hour ago. The release talked about the new project PDA. PDA is Puerto del Aire. It's a good news for us for 10 years more to operation in Mexico for the company. It's a new operation. It's a new system of mining. It's different between the Alfredo and I now. It's underground mine and mill process. It's a different process that we have now. And also for another team is today I rat with my ex boss that I send you the conversation for WhatsApp, and yes, I felt good with the conversation. I tried to know translate and no using difficult vocabulary. It's only that I know.
It was good. I told you it was good. You're talking.
Congrats, Javier.
Javier, nothing, no comments, only one, and it's about pronunciation. The grammar was perfect, man. Very good on you. At the beginning, recite. I don't know. What is the first line of your speech? You don't remember?
Recibes.
Recibimos.
Recibes.
Okay. So it will have to be received. Received.
Okay,
received. Yes, we received people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Everything was good, man. Only mm-hmm. that one. Lupita, ready? I like that. Did you drink coffee, Lupita? Are you sure? Okay, good. You can talk.
Thank you.
Here we go. All right.
Okay. Today I was remembering the class about describing place, and just this moment, casually, I heard the song in the Spotify, and I thought it was a beautiful song, so I want to tell you about her. This song is What a Wonderful World. Have you heard this song? No?
What a Wonderful World?
What a Wonderful
yes,
World.
Yes, I am.
Okay. If you hadn't heard it, I recommend that do it. The song talks about how simple and beautiful there is around us. Says something like that. I see trees of green, red rose too. I see them bloom for me and for you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. No la voy a cantar, no me les estoy diciendo de qué se trata. I see
skies
blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, dark scared night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Okay, but do you know what was the best?
What?
I understood the world song.
Oh. just listening to it? Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Did you read the
no,
lyrics
no.
or no? Okay.
No.
Did you feel satisfaction in your heart? Dun, dun, dun,
yeah.
Dun, dun, dun. Yes.
Really.
Good.
Really happy.
Very good, Lupita. Only two observations. You said, I want to tell you about her, about the song, right?
Yeah.
I want to
about
tell
it.
You about it. I want to tell you about it. And then you say, I recommend you that do it. I recommend you that do
that
it.
Do it.
Que lo hagan, ¿no?
Que lo hagan. Ajá. Si no lo han escuchado, ajá.
I recommend you to do it.
To do it.
Okay. I recommend you to do it. There you go. Perfect. Okay. Excellent. We're going to be speaking more and more. I like it. Very good for you. We're going to have a new topic today. We have that class as a concept is going to be, what should I do? Are you familiar with this question? What should I do?
No, what should I do? No.
What should I do?
Es la, ¿qué debería de hacer?
¿Qué debería de
hacer? Uh-huh, yeah, what should I do? What should I do? Alfredo, tomorrow I have a class at 7 a.m. in the morning. And I have a party tonight. What should I do?
Maybe you shouldn't drink too much.
Okay, like yes. That, right?
You shouldn't, man.
What?
No, perdón, René.
No. You, Javier.
You should grab a beer.
Grab a beer. You shouldn't grab a beer. Yes, you shouldn't grab a beer.
A lot
like
of
this,
beer.
Right? Yeah.
A lot of beer.
Okay. So that will be the environment of the class. You know, asking for, in this case, advices, right? So let's go with the introduction of the class, Mr. JC, please, number one. Your micro.
What should I do? Grammar you need. In this lesson, we'll explore how to ask for and give advice using modal verbs like should, out, to, and have better. These structures are essential for making recommendations and offering guidance in everyday situations. By the end of the class, you'll be able to engage meaningful conversation, giving and receiving advice on various problems, helping each other find the best solution.
Thank you, man. Okay. So in what cases in your real life you can use this grammar point? Like when or in what situations on your daily routine you're going to be giving or asking for advices?
For example, when you go to work and ask to your couple or to your wife or girlfriend or whatever, what shirt combines with your pants or would you choose?
Yeah. Yeah, and then you say, what should I wear?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
What should I buy? I don't know. Alfredo, you had another option. In what cases can you use this information?
Just for explain some question or some situation.
Yeah.
If you need to explain that question, no?
Yeah, okay, I gotcha. Lupita, in your case, for example, when you are working, how can you use it? Like, what recommendations do you usually ask your customers? Or what recommendations do they usually ask you, you know?
¿Qué les recomendaría yo a mis clientes, por ejemplo?
That you use this one, right? Like, oh, you should do this, you should do that, you should do this, you know?
Oh, okay. I should you maybe some flowers for the for the arrangement.
Yeah. Excellent. All right.
Depend the season.
Depending of the season. Very good.
Mm-hmm.
So talking about, thank you, Lupita. Talking about giving some advice, we will have a level, you know, we will have a level of recommendation. A level of recommendation, for example, if you go with can, it's going to be an easy recommendation, right? If you go with should, it's going to be a little bit more powerful. But if you go with must, you remember this, right?
Yes.
Okay,
may.
So.
May.
Must.
Which one?
It's the same.
El might. Isn't it?
Oh,
el might.
Yeah, might. Thank you very much. Exactly, yes.
No, no lo mismo, so, must and might.
No, no, no.
Mm-mm.
Might is like the combination of may with will.
Oh.
All right.
Future. All right. Okay.
For future, exactly.
All right.
Right? Okay. So we're going to focus today on the most popular ones. All right. So we can remember what we need. Ayer lo hablábamos, sacar la chamba. Right? Hacernos prácticos en la vida, ¿sí? Nada de complicaciones, como lo dijo Javier hoy. Right, Javier? You selected the correct vocabulary because you know it. This is what we can get, all right? If you want to give or receive recommendations, you're going to be using these three, all right? It is important to know the other ones, totally. Of course, it is important, right? So let's go with the first one. Miss Jolie, number two.
Yeah, number two. Using can to offer suggestion. Use to offer possibilities or suggest action that someone could take. Example, you can try talking to your teacher about the issue.
You can try talking, right? You can try talking now. This is, if we go back, it's something like, hey, what should I do? I have an issue with my teacher. What should I do? I have an issue with my teacher. Ah, okay, well, you can. It's just an easy recommendation. You know, you can do that. Make sense? Number three. Let's go with number three, Mr. Javier, please.
Using should for general advice. Use to give advice or recommendation that are generally
advisable.
Advisable.
Yeah.
Example, you should get more sleep if you're feeling tired.
So in this case, probably the question was, hey, Javier, I'm feeling tired. What should I do?
Okay, you should get more sleep.
There you go. So, I mean, that we are using, what should I do? What should I do? It's not a coincidence, okay? Everybody uses this expression when they want to get an advice, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it is popular to say, what can I do? Yeah, but this one is more popular. What should I do? Okay, perfect. Let's go with number four, Rene, please.
Okay, number four, using must for strong advice or obligations. Used to give a strong advice or indicate something that is necessary or obligation. Example, you must finish your break before the deadline.
Deadline. So what do you think the question was here?
What you must do?
No. You must finish. There is a terminal.
Yeah, but what is the question that you say? What should I do? You know?
Oh.
I don't remember, teacher. Can we do any question, for example, with should, and we respond with can?
Yeah. It's possible.
Yeah.
It is possible.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because you are given, it's your decision. How strong is your recommendation?
Okay.
That's why. Okay.
Okay.
So maybe the question here was, I haven't finished the project. What should I do? I haven't finished. I haven't finished the project.
Before the deadline.
Yeah, I haven't finished the project before the deadline. What should I do, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hey, Rainer, tomorrow is the present project. What happened with you? What do you
tomorrow
need?
Tomorrow is the what?
The present of the project. What do you need?
Oh. Well, you must finish the project.
Mm-hmm.
To present it.
Before
in
I
this case, I must finish the project before tomorrow because tomorrow is the deadline.
Yeah.
Right?
Sometimes I like the stress that I feel when I to be in the deadline.
Oh, me too. I like. I think that it's normal for Mexicans, right? I think so.
Maybe
you work like that under pressure.
Yes, under pressure. Uh-huh.
I don't like work.
Always all the praise for the last day.
It's like the meme, right?
We keep praying for the last day.
Estoy esperando que se me haga tarde para apurarme. That's what it's something like that.
No lo haga.
All right. Okay, one more, Mr. JC.
Forming negative sentence with modal verbs used to advise against an action or indicate something that should not be done. Example, you shouldn't keep your meals. You must not ignore this problem.
Yeah, so, I mean, if you want to give a recommendation, but a negative recommendation, you're going to use shouldn't, can't, mustn't, right?
Yes.
Mustn't. Right? It's like, I am, for example, I am getting some extra weight. I'm getting some extra weight. What should I do? Oh, you shouldn't skip your meals, right? For example, I am receiving phone calls from the bank, but I don't answer them. What should I do? What should I do? Right?
Keep doing that.
Yeah, keep doing that, please. Right? Finish, Lupita, please.
Okay. Creating question to ask for advice used to ask someone for their advice or opinion on a matter. Example, should I talk to my boss about this? Es pregunta. Should I talk to my boss about this? Can I ask for your advice on something? Must take this course to graduate?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Okay, so it's just doing the switching, right?
Mm.
To get the questions. Should I take a shower tonight or in the morning? What should I do? Right?
You'll take a shower in the night.
Okay. Should I drink coffee or should I drink tea? What should I do?
Obviously
coffee. Okay. Obviously. So
question no is for Lupita. Because
so guys,
we have
top points.
Answer.
Is the modal plus the verb, okay? Top points plus the verb in base form. So you never say should, for example, you should went. Is that correct?
No.
No, right? Base form, always base form. You should going. Is that correct?
No.
No. You should worked. Wait a minute. Worked.
No, P.
No. No, no, no. No. Nothing, okay? No.
Logical.
You should goes.
No.
No, P.
No, okay? Nothing, nothing. You should go, you should stay, you should play like that. Okay? Okay.
Or future.
In tercera persona.
In no. Exactly, exactly. Okay. No, no, no. She should go.
Only okay.
Mm-hmm. All right. Perfect. So we got the grammar. Let's go with the vocabulary, phrasal verbs, because we have a speaking activity. The speaking activity. Acuérdense que a este le vamos a dar más tiempo, ¿eh? El tiempo debido, ya habíamos dicho.
El tiempo es oro.
El tiempo es oro, mister. Number one, let's see. Javier, go for it, man. Can you?
Figure out.
Figure out.
To understand or find a solution to a problem. Figure out. Figure out.
Example.
Example, you need to figure out what's causing the issue before making a decision.
So you need to figure out, find a solution, figure out, find a solution. JC, ask me. Oh, tell me what problem do you have? What problem do you have right now? Tell me what problem do you have in this moment?
Oh, well, I have no job. I it's hard to get a new one that be equal that in that they are the old one.
Okay, equally economically talking, you
yes
mean?
Yes.
Okay, well, sorry man, sorry, figure it out. Okay, don't tell me your problems, you figure it out.
Yes,
you know,
figure
so
out.
it's something like that, you know what, I don't care, find a solution.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And it's very common that they go like this, figure it out. Como
arréglatelos,
descúbrelo, you know, figure it out. So, Alfredo, did you figure out, listen, did you figure out what was causing the noise in the car? Did you figure out what was causing the noise in the car? You got it, guys.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. No, yeah. I'm not. I'm not a mechanical guy. maybe you need to go with some shop to explain you what happened with that noise.
Yeah.
Figure
all
out.
Right. Perfect. Mr. Javier, did you figure out if you are going to have vacations next week or in 3 weeks? Did you figure out?
No, I didn't.
It didn't. Good, that's it, right? Did you figure it out? So it can be in future, okay?
I will figure out.
Yeah, it's like, oh, you know what? Don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. I will
figure out the troubles with the team.
I will figure out the troubles
with the labs team.
Yeah. With the labs team. Like that. It's a great example. Yes. I will figure it out. Yo lo resolveré, lo descubriré. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's go with number two. So this is good because usually when you get something like that, for example, hey, I don't have money for the party tomorrow. What should I do? I don't know. Figure it out.
Arréglatela.
No? Uh-huh. So it is connected with what should I do?
What should I do?
Like, get away from here, right? Something like that. Number two.
What should you do, Renee?
For problem for the money.
No.
For what?
For the party.
For the party.
In Suaki Grande.
For the Suakis, for the Rosarios Virgin.
What should
bodies?
Virgin. Oh my god, the translation is good.
Rosarios Virgin.
Yes.
Oh no.
Is correct or Virgin?
Rosarios Virgin.
Virgin, yeah.
Virgin.
Virgin Maria, yeah, it's correct. Okay. Lupita, come up with.
To think of or suggest an idea or plan. Example.
Can you come up with
a better solution to this problem?
Analyze it, guys. You understand it? Can you come up with a better solution to this problem? What will be that? What will be the substitution? Come up with. Can you
come up with a better solution to this
problem?
You do it better.
Recommend a better solution.
Can you comment?
Sugerirme.
Can you suggest?
Can you recommend another?
Can you recommend, exactly?
Can you present?
Can you present, actually?
Present.
Yeah.
Can you present?
Present. Yeah. Right? So, I can go like this. Tim, we have a problem. We have a big problem. We don't have money for the next campaign. So we need to come up with some solutions right now. Make sense? So usually when they go like that, right? Hey, Jolly, what should I do about these problems? Like, I don't know. You come up with some solutions.
We must pay on time.
We must. Exactly. Right? Come up with. You got it.
Is this paraphrase verbs is for questions or a sentence to
positives to, oh, Rene. Yeah. You want to come up? Listen, you want to come up with some examples? Do you want to come up with some examples?
It's a question.
Yeah, right now I'm doing the question. ¿Qué les estoy diciendo? Hey, guys.
¿Tú podrías darme... Do you repeat the question, please?
Yeah. We need two examples. We need two examples. Can you come up with some examples?
Okay. Mm-hmm. In a positive sentence.
Yeah. And anyhow.
You can come up.
You what?
You come up with.
You come up with.
You come up with.
You can help. You can help.
Teacher, pero en la pregunta, bueno, en la pregunta cuando use este phrasal verb, no hay que poner el contexto del problema para poderle contestar y decirle una sugerencia.
Yes, of course, right? Like the
es que
context,
estoy viendo
right?
que René está tratando de dar una respuesta, pero en sí, ¿cuál era el contexto? Pues,
I think no necessary the context, because the teacher, the question is, do you come up with examples? Is there, I don't know.
Look at this one. I need to come up with some ideas. I need to come up with some ideas for my party. So it's not necessarily in a question.
Okay.
Right? I need to come up with. Okay. Number three, ready.
1 minute for
sure.
Right in the paper.
So, Lupita, did you come up with a solution for your problem? Did you come up with a solution for your problem? You know, something like that.
Ready?
Did you find, did you discover, right? Okay, number three. This is think through. Think through. And this one, what is it? Can you help me, Mr. Javier? Think through. Your microphone.
Sorry. Think through. To consider something carefully and thoroughly.
Yes.
Example, you need to think through all the possible outcomes before deciding.
You need to think through all the possible outcomes.
Okay.
You need to think through. What do you think it is?
I need think through the consequence, consequences.
Yes.
I need to think through the consequences the consequences of my participation in the meet.
Okay, the consequences of my participation in the meet or in the meeting?
In the meeting.
Participation in the meeting. Very good. This is a good example. So, think through represents echarle cabeza. Think through, right? Mm-hmm. Piénsala dos veces. Piénsala dos veces antes de hacer algo. Think through. Okay, you need to think through.
Okay.
So usually when somebody says, hey, René, I have a problem, you know, what should I do? What should I do? And then you say, I don't know. You have two possibilities. Think through the best possibility,
mm-hmm.
you know? Something like that. Double think. Number four, ready? Help me, please, Alfredo.
Look into to investigate or explore something in more detail. Example, you should look into the option before making a final decision.
Look into.
Look into.
You need to look into. It's like look into. You know, into.
After
very, very detailed.
Decision.
Yeah. It can be in present, it can be in past, right? I will look into your file. I will check if you pass the exam. You know? Look into. So usually you go like that. Examinar, exactly, yes. Right? Very detailed. Give me examples.
After I will take a decision, I need a look into the better possibilities.
I will look into.
I will look into.
Tell me more.
Better possibilities or the most better solutions.
The best. The best solutions. Okay. I like that one. Solutions. After, this is not necessary, Alfredo. After I take, después de que yo tome, o después de que yo tome una decisión. Right?
Tiene que ser antes.
Sí.
Before I will take the decision.
Okay. Like that's correct. Yes.
Teacher, in past, for example, when I was decided to study the career, I looked into the options of careers.
Exactly, yeah. I looked into the options for the careers. Yes. Investigate, you know? Looked into. Lupita, have you looked into the Vegas newspaper to find some job? Did you check? Have you looked into the Vegas newspaper to look for a job? It's just a question, Lupita. I know that you are a happy housewife. All right. Carlos, what's up, Carlos? Turn That's down. Cool. Everything good, man. Lupita, help me, please.
De la pregunta que hizo, yo pudiera contestar, I need to look,
porque son dos verbos, I need to look into.
Okay. To refuse or reject something, often, an offer or suggestion. Example, if you're not comfortable comfortable with the offer, you can always turn it down.
Turn it down. Are you familiar with turn it down?
Turn it down.
A little bit.
It's the first time that you listen to turn down.
Turn
down. No quiero nada.
Yeah.
Regresar.
Microphone teacher. Puedo regresar.
Turn down your microphone. Trae otra caguama, Alfredo.
Come on, Alfredo. Turn down to reject.
Turn down.
To reject.
Reject.
Give me ideas.
I turned down my first job offer.
Oh, nice. My first job offer. Why?
For the money?
Because they want pay me
in pass.
Okay, because they want. No. Wanted. Yes.
Wanted
because it's with T.
Yes, wanted. Because they wanted pay me.
Connected.
To pay me 3,000 pesos.
Oh my God.
For month.
Nah. Oh my God.
Yes.
What the fuck? Good. It's good that you turn it down. Of course.
It's a real experience, Javier, or it's only an example?
No, it's real.
Oh, no. No manches, bien poquito.
Yes.
Hace 20 años, ¿no? Pero...
It's still.
Yes.
Have you ever turned down a job opportunity, René? Have you ever turned down a job opportunity?
Have you ever?
I don't understand the questions.
Have you ever?
Has rechazado, pues tú. No.
Okay.
Que se ha quedado para atrás.
No, I never. Because this job is my only job.
Okay.
First, you.
Very good. Job.
Aunque te paguen 3,000 al mes, René.
No, pero pues no me bajan 3,000 al mes.
Apenas para el inglés, René.
Ya lo sé.
Ya ahorita se lo pagan al día.
Oh, good, René. Good for you.
Fuera.
Mr. Alfredo, bite the bullet.
Bite the bullet. To endure a difficult situation, yes, that you have been avoiding, it's necessary. Example, I think it's my time, it's time to beat the bullet and talk to your boss about these issues.
Okay, what do you think it is, bite the bullet? You know?
Pues literal es morder las balas, ¿no?
Morder las balas. Ajá, pero ¿qué sería?
Pues como que enfrentarse a lo que venga, pues. Enfrentarse a lo que venga, ¿no?
¿Qué sería en español?
¿Qué es morder las balas?
Es que dijo, es como morder las... ¿Qué dijiste?
Las balas.
Las balas,
by the bullet.
Tampoco entiendo qué quiere decir
eso.
For example, here we go. I'm gonna try to give you an example. All right. Mm-hmm. So guys, we have a problem. You don't know the irregular verbs in past participle. You don't know the regular verbs, so you need to bite the bullet and memorize them. You need to bite the bullet, guys.
Hazle como quieras.
Aguántate. Okay. Hazle como quieras. Yeah. It's you need to confront. necessarily, you know, whatever, you need to buy the bullet.
Enfrentarse a lo que venga, pues.
Es como dicen, al toro por los cuernos.
Ajá, ándale.
Oh, that's a good one, yes. That's a good one.
Yo, Alfredo.
Por los cuernos.
I don't know. A ver, ahí les voy otro ejemplo. A ver si lo cachan un poco mejor. Dice, guys, I got a very, very good important contract, you know? It's gonna give me a lot of money, but I can't stand the man, you know? I don't like to talk to this company. I hate them, you know? They are very aggressive. What should I do? Should I buy the bullet and keep the contract? Or should I just not continue working for them? Or should I buy the bullet? You know what I mean?
Yeah. Pues, o sea, aguantarse, tener que soportar eso.
Pues hacer lo que sea necesario o lo justo, pues.
Sí, te tienes que aguantar. Right? You need to buy the bullet, man. I know you don't like it, but you need to buy the bullet.
Oh. The police correct. I say I should buy the bullet.
Bullet.
One more time. If what?
I should buy the bullet. Bullet.
Bullet.
Bullet.
Bullet.
Bullet. I should buy the bullet.
I should buy the bullet. Because yes. I live in my mom's house.
Ándale, eso es muy bueno.
It's for me.
Oh, René, you should buy the bullet.
Sin raspar muebles.
Some options.
Because I live in my mom's house.
Yeah.
Ha quedado muy claro. Voy ya con eso.
Alfredo, have you ever bitten the bullet in your job? And
yeah, in some cases. Around 10 years ago, and I bitten the bullet.
In paz, acuérdense que este es irregular.
Beaten.
Had to be
beaten.
Beat in paz. Mordí la bala. Years ago. Yep.
¿Por qué se ríe el Javier, viejo?
I don't know.
Lo conocí en 10 años.
Jolly, help me, please.
The ball is in your court. It's your turn to take action or make a decision. Example, I've been giving you my advice, but now the ball is in your court. Es tu decisión.
Ajá, es your decision, exactly. The ball is in your court.
La bola está en tu cancha, ¿no?
Es lo mismo, la bola está exactamente. En tu cancha.
Sí, la bola está en tu
literal,
cancha.
You can, es lo you, mismo.
You can do whatever you want with it, right?
Mm-hmm. Tú mandas, pues.
Yeah. You got it? The ball is in your court. You take that decision. I give you my options, but the ball is in your court. Usually you say this to the wife.
It's similar to the by the bullet.
Yeah.
I think. Te aguantas porque tú mandas, ya sé.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah, it's like, I don't like that cereal, but the ball is in your court. You take
aplica
that decision.
Para las mujeres, ¿no? La
yeah,
mayoría.
Very, very much. Number three, go with your gut. Go with your gut. Or you can say, go with your guts. Usually it's in plural. Go with your guts. Entrañas. Guts.
Oh, yeah.
Con todas tus fuerzas. I was in.
No.
Well, instincts. No. Look.
Instincts.
Confiar en tu instinto.
Confiar en tu instinto.
Las vísceras.
Confiar en tu instinto.
So, look at the example, Lupita. Can you help me?
When in doubt, just go with your guts. It's often right.
So, it's your intuition, right? Like, I don't know what to do, man. I don't know if I should buy the new car or I should buy the old car. You know, the pros and cons. I think this time I'm just going to go with my guts. I'm going to buy the new car. I'm going to go with my guts. Right? Le voy a hacer caso, pues, a mis entrañas.
A mi instinto.
A mi instinto. You can say, this is another expression. Relax. Trust your gut. Okay? Yes. You will take the right decision. Don't worry. Make sense?
Just do it.
Number four, go with your gut. A penny for your thoughts. A penny for your thoughts. Can you help me, JC?
All right. A penny for your thoughts. Asking someone to share what they are thinking, often to get their advice, opinion. Example, you have been quiet. A penny for you sucks.
This is when the person is, cuando decimos aquí, estás en la luna, ¿no? Que decimos, hey, estás en la luna. A penny for your thoughts. Como que te doy un penny por lo que estás pensando, right?
Como la pendeja, ¿de cuenta?
Te estoy cobrando, perdón, te estoy pagando por tus pensamientos, porque estás muy callado, right? So, imagine that we are very quiet, or imagine I'm here, right? It's like, and then you say, hey, teacher, a penny for your thoughts. Okay. Tell me what you are thinking, you know?
Okay.
A penny for your thoughts. Lo pueden usar cuando quieren una sugerencia de algo. Por ejemplo, I don't know if I should go to Cancun or I should go to Mexico City. A penny for your thoughts, Alfredo. It's like, what do you think?
Ah, okay.
Como tú qué opinas.
Tú qué opinas. A penny for your thoughts. Make sense?
Sí. Yes. A penny for
Let's finish because we need to do the speaking. Yeah. Don't burn your bridges. This is like in Spanish.
No quemes tus
puentes.
No quemes tus puentes, right? Aquí sería así, no quemes tus puentes.
No
cierres tus puertas, creo que diríamos nosotros.
Ajá, sí.
No cierres tus puertas. Don't burn your bridges. It's like, don't burn your bridges in that company. Maybe in the future you need to work in that company again.
Yes.
You know? Don't burn your bridges. Finish correctly. Yes? Lupita, did you burn your bridges here in Hermosillo, or you can come and do some events eventually?
I will do some events.
You will do some events, so. So you haven't burned your bridges yet?
No.
Good.
I do.
Alfredo, did you burn your bridges in the last company that you work?
No. I didn't.
I didn't.
I keep the doors open of that company.
You can come back and work for them, yes?
Yeah.
Very nice.
Supposedly.
Yeah, you think, right?
Yeah, I think.
All right. Let's go with the speaking activity. Jolly, can you help me, please?
Yeah. Writing and speaking. 3 minutes conversation. Exercise three. Pair up with a classmate. You will have 3 minutes to start and finish a conversation where both of you ask for advice and give advice when asked.
Okay. No nos va a dar tiempo este ejercicio. Como que no vale la pena hacerlo rápido.
In another activity for the listening, well, what should I do?
Oh, good question. What should I do? We will do it on Monday.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Right?
What do we do? 10 minutes maybe? Ya había pensado en esto, en darles free time.
All right.
Yeah,
perfect. Se desarrollen como si estuvieran. No, for speaking.
Oh.
My goodness.
Everyone?
All right. Everyone, like in a coffee place. Ready? 10 minutes. In a coffee place.
Oh, Javier. Can you drink in your free time at the mine because you are there and no are there isn't a Oxxo or whatever you want to buy some beer or alcohol or I don't know. That question is always in my mind, you know.
Okay. No, on the mind, we can't drink alcohol because it's a dry camp.
Okay.
It's named dry camp because the safety policies it not permit the alcohol here.
Okay. Until if you going to bed just for ¿cómo se dice? Para dormirse más rápido, to take the more faster you sleep. One.
Yes. Okay.
Not just to get the party inside the mind, just for rest and go sleep, for example.
I wake up 4 a.m. every day.
Right.
To 9:30 p.m. I sleep in watching TV.
Okay.
Yeah. You don't need alcohol.
Yes, I need alcohol and no pills, no tea, no nothing.
All right.
No, it's okay. You continue. Ellos tienen que quitar la palabra, right, guys?
The first one, the first day in my day off in Hermosillo,
yes.
I always am sleeping around the 9 p.m. My wife is ugly.
What the hell?
Yes, because it's my body is
used to, Javier.
It's used to.
All right. Is the same situation for you, Alfredo? I mean, no, the alcohol. I mean, the go sleep early. because your day begins very, very early the next day.
Yeah, it's same too. Javier and I, we stay at the same area on H M. It's same schedule, different activities, but same schedule. For health, or no, I'm wake up at 5 a.m.
All right.
But I go to sleep at 10 health p.m. for a couple hours on exercise. But it's the same. Zero alcohol. And
you can do exercise. You say.
Yeah.
You say you can do exercise over there.
Yeah, we have a gym on.
Oh, really? You have a space with machines and bars, yeah. And dumbbells and and mm-hmm. something like that. Really?
Yes. We have a salon of for cardio and a big one of bench press.
All right.
For,
you have a time for in during your schedule, or when you have a little bit free time, you do it.
Yeah, it's it's common after or before the
work?
12 hours work.
For all example, right.
Javier
all right.
goes at the morning, I goes at the night.
All right.
We don't have
I have an
instructor. Just
you don't have an instructor?
No.
Kendo. Okay. Oh, that's a good point, because maybe can I borrow that type of,
or maybe you can send us a couple routines.
Yes.
Yeah, you see, in my case it's different.
Right. Okay.
Because I work in my town and I live in my house, but okay. I have an option to drink, but I don't drink alcohol because I'm going to work cruda. No, it's a good option. I have a question for Lupita. Lupita, you stay in Las Vegas. What are you doing here of the activities? Are you continue with your job for the flowers? Or designer, I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I stay in Las Vegas, so my business is open in Hermosillo, with the team. They work.
Do you plan the wearing the other parties for Las Vegas? For Las Vegas.
Sí. Yes, my plan is I will work in Las Vegas in October. I will have my first event. It's a 15 party.
Wow.
Yes.
Congrats. Nice.
Yeah. Congrats. Vegas forever? Or you?
What?
You move for Vegas forever? Or no, half and half? You live in Hermosillo, you live in? Or you move your business to Vegas too?
Maybe in two countries.
Hello. Okay.
I have a advice for Javier. I think Javier, you shouldn't stress about your daughter's party. By the bullet, because every moment is ¿cómo se dice inolvidable?
Unforgivable.
Inolvidable.
And then enjoy it and give all your love to that moment.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Lupita, for your recommendation and for your...
Yoli, are you here?
I am listening your speech.
Oh, perfect. What do you think about our speech?
Okay. I need to go out 2 minutes because I have a problem in my house.
Okay.
Okay.
It's okay, the problem?
Man.
It's okay, the problem.
Yeah. It's okay.
Okay, perfect.
So, next Monday.
I need
esto
it.
Esto se va a descontrolar.
You need
esto
it.
Se va a descontrolar.
¡Está muy padre!
Yoli, tú dijiste que necesitaste salir, ¿no?
Sí.
Yeah.
Yes, sí. I need it.
Yeah. I need it to go out.
Go out.
Yeah.
I need it.
Qué emoción. See you Monday. Parece que sí va a funcionar la nueva forma. I like it.
Así está curado, ¿eh? Así está curado.
Sí, okay. Teacher.
Nos traías bien jodidos con el...
Y quiero que hagamos las lecturas en clase. Mínimo sí, una lectura a la semana. Necesitamos corregir pronunciación.
De lectura, está bien.
Sí, profe, porque de esa forma, por lo menos si no entendemos un verbo, el contexto, la oración, sí, podemos hacer las preguntas ahí. Pues, por ejemplo, yo no tengo opciones de, como Yoli, que se pone a platicar con su esposo, o le explica.
Cásate, pues. Sí, ya.
Porque no.
Ponte
eso, nada más eso.
Cásate con un gringo. Está ya. Bien, y aparte te obligas, pues te obliga a leer.
Mira, güerita, ya estás. Ya te
faltaba. Oye, Javier, pero en serio lo que te digo, disfrútalo, porque este proceso es muy bonito. Y ya cuando llegues al día y vas a ver que todo va a fluir.
Sí, ya, ya cuando hemos ensayado ahí un poquito, ya casi lloro ahí sin
nada. No, y sí vas a llorar. Sí vas a llorar de verdad. Pero es muy bonito.
Las botellas compra. Sí.
Está borrachón.
Are you? Very good. All right, guys. We'll see you Monday then.
See you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Have a nice weekend, guys. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Te miras bien con tu nuevo look, René.
Yes, right?